Oops. All right. So now that we've adjusted our numbers in our legend, how do we adjust this stuff on top? There are a couple ways to go about doing this. But the first thing we want to do is decide what we actually need displayed. So in this legend, it's showing us the raw count of total population in US counties. And I know what this means because I created this data set, so I know what all these field names and the general data set name are. But your average person doesn't need to know that. They just want to know that this is total population. Likely, I'll put a title on this legend that will, I'm sorry, a title on the map that will explain its US county population or 2018 population. So I don't, in my mind, I don't need this US county layer or this US county header. I just wanted to say total population. So the first thing I'll do is that this field name is not descriptive enough. The easiest, well, one of the ways I like to do it is if you just click on the title for the field name, you can edit your field name there. And you're not renaming it in the attribute table. It'll still be called tote pop in the attribute table. You're just renaming its display name. So we can scroll over to that. And you're not changing it, you're just changing what it looks like. You could also change that in the alias if you wanted to. And we would see that reflected here if I hadn't already changed it. So two ways to change that. So okay, I've got total population. I just want to get rid of this US county. Double-click on the legend to bring up our legend properties window. You can see we're in the Items tab. We'll click on the layer we want to change how it's being displayed and change the style. Now, this is something that takes some experience getting used to, figuring out which one of these legend item styles you want, especially because I don't always feel like the previews are very helpful. But from experience, I think this is the one I want, where it's just having the heading of the field and the label next to it. So let's see what that does to our legend. Yeah, so that one, that style option was just the heading with the label. Nothing else, no layer name, not too much else going on there. You can change this formatting. You could pick a different one. You could go through and see what they all look like. But for the speed of this video, that's the one I am looking for and probably the one you're looking for too. This is where you can also change things like if you want things in two different columns, we could add that in and you'll see how that changes your display. The last thing I want to talk about is this title legend. You should never title your legend legend. That just shows some inexperience. One of the things that I like to do is not title my legend. Some people do. In a map like this, I don't think it needs it because we're just looking at the total population for these US counties, and we'll eventually be adding in the map title. And I think that would give the user enough information. But if you need a legend name, you could add it in, but avoid legend as your legend title. So now we have a nicely formatted legend. We got rid of the weird layer names. We got, if maybe you had an underscore here, the weird field names, you could get rid of those underscores if you needed to, and make them look great in your legend.